Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Shot here.
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Second and a couple. Now Tua. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he went backwards. Third play in this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. Here's Tua by low to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Couple of Alabama guys there, two in a Waddle for the Miami first.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people, but you absolutely know they want to get this man in.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. He's sacked there by Brandon Graham, coming in and bringing him down to the ground. Defensively on the previous play, they gave up a pretty good chunk of yardage, but right there, they got a good portion of it right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They've got to figure out a big call coming up here to try and gain that yardage back.
Throwing on second and long. Tua, and they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Now, Miami getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. You know, you create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. And that is incomplete.
First down here, and that's a punch. That's a hope for this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Jake Bailey on down the punt here on fourth down. Britton Covey deep for Philadelphia. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. And the Eagles come up here first and 10 at the 20. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 7 yards there on the first down.
And that's a nice pickup on the first down on that second down run. And at that yardage,
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a
line of scrimmage, the 36 on second and 8. Now they'll switch it up here with the throw. It's coming, and down he goes. Jalen Phillips, the former first-rounder, getting in there for the sack.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Third down and 13. In motion right is Smith. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That is caught. And he's going to have the Eagles first down as they're able to get the first down conversion.
Using the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
We're scoreless after one. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. He's got his tight end. It's in the open way to now going for a gain of 7, and it'll be second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. From the 46, here's second and 3. The man in motion is Brown. On second down, Swift. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
My high school football coach was very fond of saying, you've got to meet force with force. And on a short yardage running play, that's what you're going to encounter. And how about them picking up the first down on that one?
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. They'll find Swift out of the backfield.
Defense is worried that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Here's a second and 8. He'll drop to throw. And he'll get this into the hands of Swift once again. And he is going to lose yardage here. A yard in the wrong direction. Makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage, because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Defense continues to get better and better.
a nice example there. Those guys, man, will run from their assignments and finish off that play.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game.
2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half.
This is second and eight. Here's Hurts to throw. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. And now third down and six to go. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? Exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. They'll send Brown in motion right. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Looking left side, he's got a man. That's Rockets. And the tackle made at the 13. He is well short of the first. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. So Hurts is off, and on comes Jake Elliott for the Eagle field goal. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. The kick by Elliott is good. Just before halftime, it's 3-0. So an opening drive field goal maybe doesn't whip this crowd into a frenzy, but I think that they will take the early lead.
There's no doubt about it. They may always take the early lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can break things open. But right now, this is all about letting the offense just get settled in.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. And he returns this to the 22. first down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out high. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
From the gun, it's Tua. And it's incomplete. Took a shoot. Couldn't connect.
This team is not going to make it easy for him. This physical group, when they saw the ball out play, they came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Tua sets up to pass it. Work in the middle of the field is getting that complete. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Tua now on first down. And that's incomplete. Play stops with 10 seconds left.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
Now a second and 10. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Pressure comes and down it goes. The Eagles get that to the sack. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two.
A little bit of time when you see a sack, you say, well, you blame it on the offensive line, the quarterback. But here, maybe you just tip your hat to the defender. What a play.
Yeah, and I think sometimes they just get a sense of the play before the ball's even snapped. Kind of like a sprinter anticipating the gun in a race. They're off, and guess what? The quarterback's down.
And going deep for Hill. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. The safety, Terrell Edmonds, picks it. And he will be out of bounds with no time remaining. And that will be the final action of his first half. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. On the return, Boston Scott. And it's a pretty good return here as they get this up to the 29. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe make it a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and 1 to the yard.
Getting a ton of success here so far, but but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
Brown, the motion man, right. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. He finds his man, complete. It's Rockets. Across midfield, down to 45. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for the first.
Second and short, that's a rundown. So it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 45-yard line. Oh, the motion comes too late. Now this is going to be a delay.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15. They'll get that one out quickly to Bryant. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yard is back near midfield at the 49. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long.
Hurts.
Now shotgun snap is
complete. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. Down the left sideline. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown.
So this whole game gets flipped on its ear right there. The interception, return for a touchdown, and this lead changes hands here in the third quarter.
And it certainly felt like this defense had a read on what was going on the offensive side of the ball and said, let's cut down our coverage a little bit. Let's be in a position to make a play on the ball. And boy, that sure turned out well for them.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I agree with you, too, because they've done nothing offensively in this game. Yet, they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal.
Second down and eight.
Expected, but this is a good pick.
first down.
We couldn't ask for much more at this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one-score game. First and 10 here. They will run straight ahead with Swift.
And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and getting their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Swift again on second down. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
As a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, that's
they are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
Defensive end, don't like give a scrimmage stance. They're just heading straight to the quarterback. Good recognition on that play.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And the ball comes across the air with the sandwich incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
It hurts not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it.
Tried the hard count, but to no avail.
Trying to do anything to get them to jump off sides and pick up a first down easily. Instead, it goes against them.
And give them the yards that they were desiring.
Now let's see how the offense is still out there. They like to go on 4th and 11. They're going to try and throw. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown. Against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and it's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there.
Result's not great thus far. A punt on the first drive and an interception last time out.
Now let's face it, every team wants to come out on the field and build some confidence, build some tempo, play with some rhythm. When you're making those types of mistakes, you're not getting any of that put together.
So what do you say, time to get back to the basics for them?
In a lot of ways, yes, but the biggest one, of course, is finding people who will take care of the football and make a few plays. You've got to have a drive now that calms down the entire team.
They may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try to get to the ball even faster.
is second and seven.
Again, they'll run it with Mostert. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a game of just one.
That's what happens sometimes when you're banning the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Dolphins on third down. They've hit two for four thus far. This will be third and six. Tua gonna throw. That's gonna be caught by Waddle. And he is gonna have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And they're gonna speed things up here. Tua now on first down. It's hit. Complete. Into space at the 45. Gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. 16 yards. A little deja vu from the previous play where they got 16.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. This will be caught. It's Waddle. And he has it on first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. 23 yards to pick up there.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
It's Mostert. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Hassan Reddick coming through with a stop there and a tackle for loss to boot.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
Looking to pass to it. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They need to make the play. That one was ready for the taking. Could have changed the complexion of the ball game, but it winds up incomplete.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. This crowd is turning up the decibel level. It started long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And a throw to Madden to Bralen.
That's back-to-back pass to Bralen. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletions. They're going for more.
So a big one coming now for Jason Sanders. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. Sanders' kick is good. All tied up, less than 2 minutes to go.
Back now on EA Sports as the kick teams are out here following the 2 minute warning.
Now, this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. And they'll get him down inside the 30 to 27. They'll come up first and 10 here. They'll throw on first down to Hurts. They'll find Swift out of the backfield.
He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Now Hurts going to shift him around a bit. They run out again with Swift. They'll tackle down after a game of three. Originally,
typically, we think it's the strong safeties and the better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making a big-time play?
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
A big play in this football game. Third down and one. Throwing his Hurts.
Escaping the pressure right.
And throws it out of the middle, but can't connect as that falls incomplete.
Defense only did its job. They held up in that situation, and now fourth down, you've got to punt this and try to get to overtime. There's no decision to be made, in my estimation.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. The Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game.
Who wants it more? This is fourth and a yard.
Dolphins going to take their second timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one.
They'll drop to throw. And that's complete to Bralen. And getting this chest shot in midfield and spotting the throw. First and 10, it's Hurts, eluding the pressure right.
Oh, look at this! It's intercepted! By Deshaun Elliott. And the Dolphins are going to have it here just past the 25.
They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending the play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball. And that one was picked off.
Oh, look at this. It's intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury.
And he'll get up all the way down inside the 35-yard line.
We say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally, and that is a big one here in a tie-ball game in the fourth quarter.
And Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes, and that was one of our Madden Petras back at Tennessee. Coach Measures say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
This is first and 10. On first and 10, it's Swift.
And he's going to take this one down to the 25. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. The kick by Emmett is good. The sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. And you know what, an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent out there or a solid pro like this? It's just pretty evident to me.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here's first and 10. Tua.
He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And they were just hoping for something to go their way. A tip ball, a penalty, anything to get them within shouting distance, a field goal range. But now, with the clock where it is, this is going to take something close to a miracle to pull this one out.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner. Although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken.